Hi, my name is Richard Wright. I'm an 18-year-old black boy living on my own in Memphis, Tennessee. So far, my life has not been easy. From my childhood to my current position, I've been struggling. Whether it be concerned with hunger, people, religion, or my dreams, there's always something to worry about. So, let's start from the beginning. As a child, I was certainly a troublemaker. At the age of 4, I managed to burn our house down. I remember hiding under the house. I was so scared of my parents' reaction that the thought of dying there never occurred to me. I just wanted to see how the pretty curtains would look engulfed in flames. I was foolish back then. My wonder always conquered my common sense. They do say curiosity killed the cat. Oh, actually, that's another story. My dad had told me to kill a cat that had wandered by our house. I knew he hadn't really meant for me to kill the kitten, but my deep hate of him urged me toward the literal acceptance of his word. Also, at the age of 6, I was a drunkard. I would go into the nearby saloon, someone would buy me a drink, and I would repeat phrases for a nickel. I did this for a while, until my mother found out. Well, of course I was beaten. I was beaten with a switch for all of these incidences, and I sure deserved it. But what we didn't deserve was our poverty. Once my father left us, it was even harder to get food on the table. I was hungry all the time, and eating was my primary concern. I still experience that constant hunger, but I've other things to worry about too. Now, another thing that greatly affected my childhood was religion. As a kid, my mother would take me to church. There was a lot of pressure on me to be saved, especially by my grandma and other kids. But to do that, you had to express your belief in God and in Jesus. At that time, I had not settled in my mind whether I believed in God or not. His existence or non-existence never worried me. From your sleep, the drying of your tears. But alas, I was trapped by community, that is, the church community. They wanted me to become a member. Eventually, I was baptized. This is because my mother came to me in front of the whole church and begged me to be brought to God. But at that point, it was no longer a question of my believing in God. It was a simple, urgent matter of public pride. If I refused, it meant that I did not love my mother, and I would embarrass her in front of everyone. Even after being baptized, religion still bored me, and I wasn't alone. Other boys would go to sleep during Sunday school. Finally, the boldest of us confessed that the entire thing was a fraud, and we would skip church. It just didn't seem important.
Was walking side by side. Me and the devil, ooh, was walking side by side.
The relationship between whites and blacks has followed me basically all my life. When I was young, I never really thought we were different. I was pretty isolated then, but now, since I'm on my own and I need jobs, this relationship really matters. Back in Mississippi, I was always being fired from my jobs because of my attitude, my speech, the look in my eyes. I didn't know how to act towards white people. Subservience doesn't come naturally to me. Surviving in this society is difficult. Memphis isn't much different than Mississippi either. What have us blacks done to deserve what we have to deal with day after day? It's just not fair. I have a thirst for reading, but because I'm black, I can't check out books from the nearby library. Mr. Falk, a man who works at the optical company, has lent me his card, so I've been able to get books and read them. The problem with reading these books is that I now know how much I've missed out on and will never be able to experience. I've been trying to write as well. I still aspire to be an author. Each time I try, though, I get frustrated. My writing just isn't as good as the authors I've been reading. I still have plans to go to Chicago. I just know things are going to be different there. I'll get more opportunities, and then I'll be able to experience more. I've been talking to some men from work about it, and they say black folk change when they go up north. But that's what I want to do. When I go to Chicago, I'm going to change.
California, my sweet home, Chicago.